In this video, we're going to discuss the difference between retained earnings and net income. So net income is just a company's profit for a set period of time. Could be for a quarter, for a month, for a year. It's telling you how profitable this company was. Okay. Retained earnings, on the other hand, is all the profits the company has ever had since the very first day that they opened their doors for business, minus any dividends that they've distributed to their shareholders. Okay, so you could think about this as profits that the company has kept and chosen to reinvest in the business. If they pay the profits out to the shareholders in the form of dividends, then they obviously haven't been reinvested in the business. So retained earnings and net income are related in the following way. So let's say we have a company, we have 3 years of business. So we've got year one, year two, and year three. And we see that on year one, the net income for the company is $100, and there are no dividends declared. Let's say there's no dividends. So at the end of year one, the retained earnings would be $100. Now, year two, the company again has $100 of net income, and again, no dividends. So the retained earnings at the end of year two would be $200. Now, year three, let's say the company again has net income of $100 for year three. And then now let's say this time there's dividends of $25 that are paid out. Now, the retained earnings at the end of year three is going to be $275. Now, see, the net income in each case, the net income, this is just for year one. This is just the net income for year two. This is just the net income for year three. It's just for a set period of time. But look at the retained earnings balance is basically a running balance. It's keeping a running tally of all the profits that have ever been earned. And then we subtract out, of course, the dividends. The reason this isn't 300 is because we subtract the 25, because that 25 is being distributed back to the shareholders. So obviously it has not been reinvested in the business. Now this retained earnings account, you would see that on the company's balance sheet in the stockholders' equity section. And the net income you would see on the company's income statement. Let me show you an example with Kroger. Okay, so Kroger, here's comparative balance sheets for 2 years, okay, for Kroger. And I've just got the stockholder equity section. I left the assets and liabilities out so as not to have information overload. So here's our retained earnings account. They call it accumulated earnings, but it's the same account. They started at $15.543 billion and they went up to $17.007 billion. Why did that happen? Well, they had net income, right? They had net income over the period. Between those two balance sheet dates, they have $1.907 billion in profit, okay? And that's going to increase the retained earnings. And you can see that in the statement of stockholders' equity. So we see that they start with $15.543 billion of retained earnings. Then they added $1.907 of profit. Okay, $1.907 billion, I should say, of profit. But then they also declared some dividends. They distributed some of those profits to their shareholders. So that's subtracted. That's why that's in parentheses. And that's how they ended up with an ending balance of retained earnings of $17.007 billion. And if you didn't quite follow that, here's a handy formula. So you start with the retained earnings, the beginning balance. Then you add any net income or subtract if there's a net loss, if the company lost money. Then subtract the dividends, and that gives you the ending balance of the company's retained earnings. So that's how we got to this $17.007 billion. It was just this plus this minus this gives you that. So the net income account from the income statement affects the retained earnings account on the balance sheet.